What's up, good peoples? So, look, listen, man. I'm trying something a little bit different today. You know, I'm trying to see if y'all prefer this type of style with the, you know, big format and all that, flat screen TV type shit. I normally used to do with the handheld because it was just easier for me. And, this is a little bit of an adjustment. I could try to see if it would make it work. If y'all feel like you really like it, of course, let me know in the comments, you know. My video today is I wanted to talk to you guys about dancing. I was watching this reaction that this white girl on YouTube did. I think it was like BluTube or something like that. And she was reacting to Big L, Put It On. And you know, she was talking about the Maltese and all that. She was like, oh, yo, like, she loved just the way that Big L was rhyming on it. And while that's important and that's dope, I think one of the things that people forget in this hip-hop shit, and this is why I always sort of sound like a preacher on it, is that to me, hip-hop is about dancing. It's about the music. It's about the way the shit makes you feel and makes you vibe and bop. And that's why, to me, I'm just gonna come out and say it. If I can't dance to your song, I feel like your song was trash. That's just the fact of the matter. Like, and that's why I have a hard time listening to the opinions of people who can't dance on hip-hop. Because if you can't dance, it's like, well, your biggest way of, your meter, the way you judge a song is just completely off, right? Because hip hop is dancing music. It's meant for us to be free and wild out. It's an aggressive, fun type of dance, right? At the end of the day, right? Like, all the greatest rappers do it. And the thing is, when people talk about dance, you're like, oh, your average sort of underground lame is going to be like, oh, the club, blah, blah, blah. It's not about the club, man. You know what I mean? Like, hip-hop is a social music, right? I got into an argument with someone on Facebook, a week ago about this. And he was like, oh, well, MF Doom, you can't play MF Doom in the club. You kind of could. You know what I mean? Like, you could play accordion, right, among hip-hop heads. Now, of course, you could play it amongst casuals. But accordion as a song goes. You know what I'm saying? If you hear it loud, it's got a swing to it, right? That you can kind of get into, right? I mean, at the end of the day, all of MF Doom's great songs have a swing to it. You could technically dance to those records, right? Like, in fact, every great rapper that you can think of, all of the guys that do the Maltese and all that shit, a lot of all those guys were former dancers themselves. They were b-boys, they were graffiti writers. They did a lot of stuff hip-hop-wise, right? Think about it. Like, think about Nas. Nas is a great dancer. Nas is an I Am video going like this and shit. You know what I mean? Nas can dance. Like, if you look at his IG, like, he's not rhythmically challenged or some shit. You know what I'm saying? He's able to kind of bop a bit, right? Ray and Ghost, they were dancing. I mean, there's videos of them online dancing to Rakim records and stuff like that. I mean, you look at Bobby Shmurda. Bobby Shmurda's big cosign came when Jay and Beyonce were dancing to Hot Nigga when they were performing at Barclay, right? So, like, all the greatest rappers can dance. I mean, if they couldn't dance, they wouldn't be able to come up with that fly shit that they come up with. Because they're so good with the rhythm, and that's how they're able to come up with these flow patterns and figure this shit out, right? That's how they're able to decide to go on a beat as opposed to, let me just ride that out, blah, blah. Because they're in the booth swagging, right? If you're not swagging, like, how are you going to come up with some cool shit? And that's my point. Like, if I can't dance to your shit is trash. Right? I hope this doesn't get blocked. I'm going to check this out with Big L and give you a perfect example, right? And I'm going to stand up and, you know, work it out a bit. But Big L is a perfect example of this, right? Because people like to use Big L as, like, the Maltese and stuff like that. But I think people miss the point about what made Big L and some of his songs so fucking ill. They were just good songs. They were great songs. Like, you could really dance to them, right? You know? You know, like, when this shit come on, you just like, you know what I mean? Like, if you can't rock to this black music that we make, what's the point? You know, let me stand up for shit, right? You know what I mean? Like, you should be, hey, yo, you better flee hops, raise your ass off three blocks, and I'll see exactly so I'm talking like three blocks. Out. I got the last thing I always been a foul child. My guns go boom, boom, and young guns go loud, pow. Mighty But you know what I mean? Like, that's the point. That's what I'm trying to tell you, man. Like, this hip-hop shit, you're supposed to, you know what I mean? You're supposed to have fun with it. Like, and most of these guys, let me pause this for a second. A lot of these guys that do these reviews online, I know they can't dance. I look at them shits. You know what I'm saying? These are not people that enjoy the music. Like, if the music came on, they can't dance to the shit. I've told you personally, I've seen Rosenberg out when I was in New York. You know what I mean? I'm in Manhattan. I'm at a DJ party, whatever. And I see Rosenberg just standing there. DJ's playing classics. Rosenberg's just standing there. So why would I listen to Rosenberg's opinion on hip-hop? He clearly don't really feel it like that. Yeah, he DJ'd in Maryland and all that shit. That's cool. I don't care. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you don't really feel this music, you don't really have a stake in it. And if you don't really have a stake in it, then why the fuck am I even listening to your opinion on it? You know what I mean? I can be friendly and, you know, listen to it for a second. But in general, like, I'm just not going to care what you think. If you can't dance, what's the point? You know what I mean? And I think that's where people, they miss this stuff, man. Like, let me give you another example, because y'all love to hate the trolls in the comment section. Here's a perfect example of a song that I absolutely love and why I fuck with Playboi Carti, because his music is very danceable to me. You know, you hear Carti out, Carti should be blown up. You know what I mean? Like, you just gotta play these songs, right? Look at this. You know what I mean? Look at how that. Just that shift, not shuffle. I mean, and hip-hop's great, like, because you can do whatever you want, really. As long as you're on beat, you know? You know, you can do whatever you want. You just gotta be on beat. You know what I mean? If you want to be serious about this shit, let me show you something. But it, you know, the kids be doing this, whatever, like, I don't get it with the little kids, they get these dances and shit that they do. This shit that they do, I mean, that's not for me, I'm too old for that. But the point is that it's supposed to make music that make people bop. That's what I'm talking about with this. You take a shot and you miss. Clear like a dish. So, yeah. If all you take from that is, like, I'm crazy, whatever, take that. That's cool with me. But the point is that you need to get into, you know, hip-hop is about dancing, man. Like, you know, you look at the forefathers of this shit. You know, it comes from James Brown. James Brown was out here dancing. You know what I mean? Like, the parties. I follow these guys, man. I follow the pioneers on Instagram. You know, MC Debbie D, one of the pioneering female rappers on IG. Great lady. And, you know, I see the posts she makes and what she talks about. And it's fun music. It's the core of it is for people to get out and just express themselves. You know what I'm saying? In a way that gets the party going. Right? So if your shit ain't making me do this and bounce and have a good time, what am I listening to you for? You know, and now you can say, oh, again, people have used that argument with Nas and Jay, oh, you know, they not out here making club music with Nas. Nah, like, Illmatic is a fucking banger. The whole thing is bangers. You can play all those songs at hip-hop parties and people would love it. Every one of them shits hits. I've been at parties that play Illmatic songs. You know what I'm saying? It ain't hard to tell. Got you going like this. One time for your mind. You know what I mean? If your music don't do that for me, it's trash. So I talk about these Griselda lames and the Kendricks and shit like that. Their music don't do nothing like that for you. They just don't. I know who they make it for. They're making it for people that can't dance, aka white people that don't really listen to hip hop like that. You know what I mean? Like the multis, like, oh, how many multis they got? Nah, man. Nah, that's not hip hop. You know what I'm saying? When Rakim came on the scene, I was a fiend ever since I was a teen. You know what I'm saying? That beat, you know what I mean? That's hard. That's why we say this shit's gotta be hard. And it's supposed to, you know, get you going, all right? So, y'all have a good one. Let me know what you think about this, you know, sort of size of video and stuff like that. And, you know, I'll try and see if I want to do more of these. You know, it's a bit of a setup thing going on for me. But if y'all love it, I'll rock with it. If not, I'm going to go back to the old, that fashioned handheld thing, all right? Later.